Thanks for joining us for CBN News Today. I'm Ephraim Graham.
And I'm Charlene Aaron. It was the second time in recent weeks that a Christian organization has been the target of an attack in Afghanistan. This time, three American doctors killed. Some may ask the question, why work in such a dangerous place? But the widow of one of the doctors is saying the opposite and has a message of her own for the man who killed her husband. Caitlin Burke has the story.
Dr. Jerry Umanos loved the Afghan people. He'd been working in the country for the last 7 years through the Christian organization Cure International. His wife says it was his calling.
He always had a desire to be the hands and feet of Christ. He was always a light for Christ, and he had a love and commitment that he expressed for the Afghan people because of that love for Christ.
The Cure International Hospital was founded in 2005 by invitation of the Afghan Health Ministry, and it treats about 37,000 patients a year. 2 years ago, Dr. Umanos spoke about the lives the hospital has helped save.
Most of these kids here would be dead. There's very few other facilities that can take care of kids this small and do well.
His wife says her husband would want others to open their hearts to the Afghan people, just as he did. And she offered a message of forgiveness to the gunman.
Our family has suffered a great loss. We don't hold any ill will towards Afghanistan in general, or even the gunman who did this.
Investigators are still trying to find a motive for the shooting. The gunman was taken into custody after being treated by the very hospital he attacked.
He shot himself after the attack. He was initially treated at the Cure Hospital and has now been transferred out of our facility into the custody of the government of Afghanistan.
Along with Dr. Umanos, two other American doctors, a father and son, were also killed, and a female healthcare worker was injured.
Please join us in praying for the families of the victims and those affected by the shooting, as well as the peace in Afghanistan.
Caitlin Burke, CBN News.
Dale Brantner is CEO of Cure International. He is with us now. Sir, our prayers are with your organization today. What can you tell us about the motive behind the attack?
Well, it's thank you for that. It means a lot to all of us and also the families. But in regards to motive, it would just be speculation at this point. We're working with the Afghan authorities, and we're not trying to really speculate what the motive could be. If you were asking what my gut is, I would guess that it's more politically motivated. Cure has operated in Afghanistan for the last 12 years, just getting established there shortly after 9/11/2001. And we've been able to function there openly as a Christian entity. And we've never had anything quite like this occur before.
Now, you said you've been there 12 years. How will this affect your work going forward?
Well, you know, every day within Cure, in the 30 countries that we serve, we're always doing threat assessments on where we serve, and we take security very seriously. But in regards to Afghanistan, this isn't going to change our resolve. Jerry was a friend and a colleague, and he poured out his life there for the last 7 years, which has been remarkable. He loved the Afghan people, as his wife clearly articulated. And if Jerry was able to speak into the situation, he would want us to continue to have that resolve to serve the people that he gave his life for. And, you know, when I think of Jerry, I'm not going to just think about the shortness of his life. I'm going to think about the thousands of Afghan children that he was able to save. I mean, he came to Afghanistan and through the Cure International Hospital, didn't just take care of the least of these. He took care of the smallest of these because his focus was on premature babies that were born in our hospital there. And so his legacy is going to live on in the lives of these kids who are going on to be doctors themselves, police officers, teachers, and maybe some will even lead the nation one day.
Wow. Tell us about Cure's mission and the work of its doctors, as you mentioned Dr. Jerry as well. Tell us about the other doctors.
The other doctors, you mean that were killed?
The mission.
Oh, just the mission of Cure International globally.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Cure International established 17 years ago. We're in 30 countries with hospitals in 10, and our specialty programs of clubfoot and hydrocephalus spanning the remaining countries. We do around 20,000 surgeries a year. We're primarily focused on children. and we're about the gospel. We come in to not just restore the broken bodies of children, but also the broken relationship between God and mankind. And so we call that our 50-50 ministry, if you will. And so it's equally important for us to deal with temporal suffering as well as alleviating eternal suffering. And the kinds of doctors that come to serve with Cure are really special. The majority of our doctors are actually from the countries that we serve in, because we set up a teaching system within our network from day one. And so we do a lot of training of surgeons, of nurses, of midwives around the world. And then the few expats that leave their practices in the West, they leave high-paying jobs. They're motivated for doing what Jesus did. You'll hear me often say that we don't sit around a Cure and talk about or wonder what would Jesus do. We look in the Gospels and we see what Jesus did. He proclaimed the kingdom of God and he healed the sick. And that's what motivates the doctors that come and serve with Cure in these underserved parts of the world.
Beautiful. Dr. Brandon, thank you so much for your time. We appreciate it.
My pleasure. Thank you.
Israel has left the U.S.-backed peace talks with the Palestinians. Israel made the move after the Palestinian government Fatah faction decided to rejoin with Hamas, which the U.S. and Israel classify as a terrorist group.
Following the decision by the Palestinian government to forge an alliance with Hamas, an organization that calls for the destruction of the Jewish state, we have decided to suspend all the negotiations with the Palestinians. They cannot say they're a peace partner if they're embracing the most violent and extreme enemies of peace.
Hamas has fired more than 10,000 rockets at Israel in the last few years. Israel says it will return to the talks if Fatah drops the agreement with Hamas.
President Obama is in South Korea today on the second stop of his four-country Asian tour. Obama's visit comes during a time of mourning for the Asian nation. Rescue crews are still struggling to recover bodies from last week's sunken ferry. Officials investigating the cause of the disaster are looking at what the ferry was carrying besides the passengers and crew. A naval expert says a load of more than 3,600 tons of cargo could have set the ship tipping over with a significant turn. Obama and the South Korean president held a moment of prayer for the victims of the tragedy.
Oregon could become the first state to drop its problem-plagued online health exchange and replace it with the federal website. The state's board is deciding today whether to follow that recommendation from an advisory committee. A health official estimates that fixing the existing system will cost about $78 million and take too long. Making the switch to the federal system would cost the state $4 to $6 million. With that option, Oregon would use healthcare.gov for private policies, but continue using its current system for Medicaid enrollments.
Oregon officials are horrified to learn medical waste that includes aborted fetuses might be being burned to generate electricity. Commissioners Sam Brentano and Janet Carlson ordered an incinerator to stop burning the medical waste that comes from a Canadian company. Both strongly oppose abortions. The commissioners suspended the shipments of waste until procedures are in place to ensure no fetal tissue is burned. The decision comes a month after reports that officials in the UK use fetal remains to generate power at medical facilities.
Fewer active duty soldiers are taking their own lives, but the amount of reserve soldier suicides is still going up, passing the amount of active duty suicides last year. The opposing numbers suggest limitations to prevention programs designed to help at-risk service persons. Once soldiers are no longer in active service, they don't have the same access to support networks, including military medical or mental health services. Military leaders say that some programs appear to be working, but it's too soon to declare success in the battle against suicides.
This Sunday, Pope Francis will oversee an historic event. Two popes, Pope John the 23rd and Pope John Paul II, will become saints. Our Heather Sells has more on the double honor.
Vatican observers believe that Pope Francis approved the two popes for simultaneous sainthood to signal this, that Catholics of different views are welcome in the church. Francis is honoring Pope John the 23rd, who served from 1958 to 1963 and is known for his modernizing reforms. Conversely, Pope John Paul II, who served from 1978 to 2005, is known for upholding orthodoxy and doctrine and putting some controls around the earlier pope's reforms.
From the moment he took office, Pope John Paul stood as a symbol of faith and freedom for his homeland of Poland, caught in the grip of communism.
Shortly after becoming pope, he returned to Poland, where his anti-communist stance endeared him to the Solidarity movement. He is credited, along with Ronald Reagan and British Prime Minister Margaret Thatcher, for helping bring down communism in Eastern Europe.
John Paul II always said that he was not Superman who let the communism fall. He said the tree was rotten. I just shook the tree.
Many also remember John Paul as the first truly global pope. He visited more than 120 countries, the most ever for a pope, and held audiences with more than 17 million people. There remains a stain on his legacy, however, the sex abuse scandal that festered for years on his watch.
Certainly he was against sex abuse. He was toughly against sex abuse. But he should have opened an investigation about the founder of the Legionaries of Christ, Marcel Maciel.
Despite this, many now call John Paul the Great, in honor of his efforts to fight communism and inspire a new generation of Catholics. And in Poland this week, the government is supporting an exhibit entitled Pope of Freedom, in recognition of his rise to sainthood. Heather Sells, CBN News.
Coming up, good news for the 80 million Americans suffering from heart disease, how the Mayo Clinic is helping them take back their health.
Millions of Americans with an ostomy live their lives to the fullest every day. And over the last 10 years, thousands have chosen Liberator Medical as their caring and reliable resource for ostomy supplies. Liberator Medical is a nationally accredited Medicare, Medicaid, and insurance provider, so we can handle all your Medicare, Medicaid, and insurance paperwork and billing. And Liberator Medical has been chosen as a preferred supplier by all the leading ostomy manufacturers, including Coloplast, Hollister, Convatec, and Generics. We supply all these leading ostomy brands so you can always get the ostomy supplies and accessories you want and trust. And all of our ostomy care specialists are product certified by the manufacturers. Shipping is free and discreetly delivered right to your door. Unhappy with your present ostomy supplier? Call Liberator Medical and ask about our free ostomy sampling program. We also offer catheters and urological supplies.
Call 1-800-513-3076. That's 1-800-513-3076.
Pat Boone here with some good news you can trust. Today, our faith, families, and our freedoms are under attack. Polls say 2 out of 3 Americans no longer trust government. A stalled economy, weakening dollar, and politicians willing to steal money from our children to waste on unfixable problems. So, whom can you trust? Well, our money still says in God we trust. But do we? Or have we quietly allowed the things we hold sacred to be stolen by the enemies of traditional values? Today, our government spends almost twice its income, running up a tab for future generations into the hundreds of trillions. How can you stop this from happening to your family? Well, it's all covered in a fantastic new book, The Great Withdrawal, by Craig Smith and Dr. Lowell Ponte. Every American needs to read this book. Why don't you call now for a free copy of The Great Withdrawal? It's the simple truth you can trust.
More good news about the health benefits of dark chocolate. A new study says it could help prevent obesity and type 2 diabetes. Researchers tested key ingredients in the cocoa in dark chocolate on lab mice, and they found that they could help prevent excessive weight gain and could even bring down the levels of blood sugar. Previous research has found that dark chocolate can also be good for your heart and your brain, and it contains antioxidants as well as vitamins and minerals.
And while you're munching on your dark chocolate, there are many other things you can do to improve your heart health. And that's something many Americans need to do because 80 million people in the U.S. have some form of heart disease. Lori Johnson shows us the simple plan the Mayo Clinic is using to try and reduce that number.
Heart disease is the number one killer of men and women, but an astonishing 80% is preventable. Dr. Martha Grogan is a cardiologist at the prestigious Mayo Clinic. She says even small lifestyle changes can make a big difference. She lays out a simple plan in the new book, Mayo Clinic Healthy Heart for Life, that includes eating 5 fruits and vegetables a day.
Eating a more healthy diet sounds hard to some people, but don't worry about the things you can't eat. Just focus on the things you can eat. So try to eat 5 fruits and vegetables a day, and you'll be full. You won't eat as much junk food.
We all know that smoking is bad for your heart, but did you know that sitting most of the time is just as bad? A sedentary lifestyle doubles your chance for a heart attack. But the good news is even a little bit of exercise can make a big difference. Just 10 minutes a day can cut your chance of a heart attack in half.
If you do more activity, you'll benefit even more. But people have gotten into the habit of thinking that 10 minutes is nothing, and it's not.
Getting 8 hours of sleep a night should be considered a necessity, not a luxury, because sleep deprivation has devastating effects on your heart.
One of the most important things about sleep is that getting adequate sleep can help people lose weight. So it not only protects you from heart attacks, but it helps you maintain a healthy weight.
And finally, be joyful, because negative emotions like anger, anxiety, grief, and loneliness can damage your heart. So changing to a heart-healthy lifestyle is easier than you think. And as an added bonus, you'll also reduce the risk of stroke, Alzheimer's, and cancer. Lori Johnson, CBN News.
Up next, an explosive growth of Christians in a country where 99% of the population are Muslims. We'll show you where this revival is happening.
Attention, sleep apnea patients. Are you tired of the expense and hassle of getting your CPAP and BiPAP supplies? Are you fed up with dealing with ill-fitting, leaking, or worn-out masks and straps? Are you worried about the effects that unsanitary tubes, cushions, and filters have on your health? If you said yes to any of these questions, Allied Medical Supply Network has the solution to your problems. You could qualify to have your supplies regularly delivered right to your door at little or no cost to you. That's right, no more inconvenience, no worn-out masks and straps, no more unsanitary equipment, just restful sleep. Call Allied Medical Supply Network today to determine if you may qualify to receive your fresh, brand-name supplies at little or no cost. Don't delay. Call us now to see if you are eligible to save money on regular delivery of your CPAP and BiPAP supplies. Call 1-800-815-9947. That's 1-800-815-9947. Or go to CPAPSupplyHelpline.com.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans, with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need, just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right, you could save up to 85% on your prescriptions, just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card, just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
It's an area that was once hostile to the gospel, but now an amazing revival is moving through the northernmost reaches of Africa.
And as George Thomas shows us in this exclusive report, tens of thousands of Muslims are turning to Christianity.
These images of North Africans worshiping have never been seen before on television. As the sun sets over the Mediterranean Sea, Muslims across this part of Africa are converting to faith in Jesus Christ in record numbers.
What God is doing in North Africa, all the way from actually Mauritania to Libya, is unprecedented in history of missions.
Tino Kahush, a graduate of Regent University, has spent years traveling the region to document the transformation.
I have the privilege of recording testimonies and listening to firsthand stories of men and women, all ages, where they can be sitting in a room and see the appearance, the presence of God appear to them in reality. It's like a vision. They can, some of them gave me stories of they carry a conversation. It's not just a light that appears.
His interviews confirm what experts say is a profound move of God in the predominantly Muslim nations of Mauritania, Western Sahara, Morocco, Algeria, Libya, and Tunisia.
Sometimes I feel jealous. How come is visiting the Muslim world at this time and age where we don't hear that happening in the traditional Christian community?
From the shores of Casablanca in Morocco to Tripoli, Libya, experts say the growth of Christianity, especially in the last 20 years, has been unprecedented. And nowhere is that growth more evident than in the North African nation of Algeria.
In fact, we never thought the Algerian church would grow so big.
Pastor Salah leads one of the largest churches in Algeria, where 99% of the population is Muslim. He says every new Christian in his church came from a Muslim background. Some 1,200 believers attend the church.
In fact, since we started as a church until today, we've baptized on average 150 to 160 believers per year.
Men like Zeno, who was invited to attend Pastor Salah's church by a friend.
I saw Algerians worshiping God with all their hearts, and it touched me.
Others like Farhat speak of miraculous encounters. He says he was illiterate and couldn't read the Bible when he accepted the Lord. Then God made a change.
Since then, I've read the Bible and understood the word of God. This is just an example of what God has done in my life. And this is the case of many, many people here in Algeria.
Even though Algeria is overwhelmingly Muslim, the government has given Protestant churches the freedom to register their congregations.
It is the first Muslim Arab government who recognized officially churches from Islam.
Yusuf Kurahmani is a leading Algerian pastor. He says the government will harass and intimidate Christians from time to time, but the level of persecution is nothing like it was 20 years ago.
God has given us many opportunities to witness at the police stations, at the courts. And actually, once I went to the police station, and they gave me 45 minutes to speak about Jesus. Just imagine yourself, they are all Muslims. Titi, well, tell us about Jesus, please.
But Algeria and the countries of North Africa weren't always open to the gospel. Peter is a veteran missionary in these parts.
You know, there's that parable, the sower went out to sow and the seed fell on stony ground. This is North Africa. In those days was quite resistant and stony.
For security reasons, we've altered his voice and concealed his identity.
The religion and the culture were unsympathetic to anything that was foreign, and Christianity was considered to be a religion of the Europeans.
Peter believes the arrival of satellite TV and the internet have dramatically changed people's perception of Christianity.
Today in North Africa, on TV, you can hear native Arab Christians talking about their faith, who are mature Christians, answering questions, involved in debates.
Emboldened by God's power, Algerian Christians are now on a mission to take the gospel to the four corners of the globe.
God has put in our heart to be able to send 1,000 missionaries by the year 2025. And I really believe maybe one day America will end up with some Muslim converts, missionaries coming to reach out to the Muslims there and other parts as well.
George Thomas, CBN News, along the shores of the Mediterranean.
And you can see more inspiring stories about the work of the church around the world on our Christian World News program. Simply log on to cbnnews.com to find the page. We'll be right back.
Do you have an idea for an invention or a new product? Brian and Alice Jagosh, the inventors of the Halftime Drill Driver, did. They invented a power drill attachment that lets you drill, flip, and drive in seconds. Brian and Alice licensed their invention to the company that brought you the Snuggie, and it's now selling in major retailers nationwide. Look for the InventHelp caveman on the package. If you have an invention that you would like to try to patent and submit to companies for possible review and want free information on how InventHelp may be able to assist you, call now. InventHelp is America's largest inventor service company with sales offices in more than 60 cities nationwide. Call InventHelp today for free information. Our clients made a financial gain with their invention, but this is just their individual result. Brian and Alice's experience is not typical, as only a very small number of inventions are licensed or sold in stores.
For your free inventor's information, call 1-800-559-8567. That's 1-800-559-8567.
If you had a choice between going bald and a full head of hair, which would you choose? Advances in medical science have resulted in the world's first and only permanent solution to hair loss.
Yes!
You wash it, you cut it. It's your own real, naturally growing hair. When it comes to hair restoration, no one in the world has more experience than Bosley. The results look completely natural and are affordable on nearly any budget. But the entire process can't be explained in 60 brief seconds. So to find out more about this clinically proven and permanent solution to hair loss, call now to receive your free no-obligation information kit. It'll answer all of your questions about hair loss and hair restoration. Plus, we'll also send you this $250 gift certificate just for calling. Every day you wait, you're losing more hair. So don't put it off any longer. You owe it to yourself to find out the facts. Choose hair. Choose Bosley.
Call 800-868-9957. That's 800-868-9957.
Well, the weekend is here, and that means it is time for our regular family-friendly movie reviews with Bob Waliszewski. He is the director of Focus on the Family's entertainment review department called Plugged In Online. Bob, let's start with the new action movie about an undercover cop who tries to take on a dangerous crime boss. What did you think of Brick Mansions?
You know, it's rated PG-13, and this is Paul Walker's last film before he died. I will describe the entertainment as being plot holes everywhere and unbelievability everywhere. For instance, if there's three bad guys with submachine gun and Paul Walker's character is 30 feet away and everyone's shooting nonstop, they're gonna miss him. From a family perspective, lots of language, lots of violence. I gave it a 2 out of 5 for family friendliness. Really a mess of a film.
All right, well, last week you had two bright spots, Heaven Is For Real, as well as the new documentary called Bears. Did they make a big impact at the box office?
You know, Heaven Is For Real, the initial reports that came in at number 3 at the box office, but people of faith have a habit of going to movies on Sundays, which weren't tallied in the original. And by the time those figures came in, it actually bumped Heaven Is For Real to number 2. I like this film. I think it sets out well to do what it wanted to do, which was to say to skeptics that they're not sure there is a heaven, that there really is a heaven. This is Jesus's heaven. The other film, Bears, didn't do so well at the box office. It came in at number 11. It's just such a good family film. It deserved better. It's rated G. I gave it a 5 out of 5 for family friendliness. There are a few moments of peril, but everything resolves itself well. Parents know that if you have young kids, 6, 7, 8, 9, be acceptable. And you're thinking, oh no, what did I bring them to? Know before you go that it's gonna work out. It's gonna work out.
All right, Bob, thank you so much.
You bet, Jeffrey.
Well, that's going to do it for now on CBN News Today. You can find more of our exclusive coverage of the issues you care most about at cbnnews.com.
Certainly hope you'll join us again next time. Make it a fabulous Friday and have a wonderful weekend.
Inside every child is a hero, a leader, a friend to others. Someone who helps out, who does the right thing, who dreams of what they can be, but they still need our help.
What should I do?
What should I say?
How should I feel?
That's where Superbook comes in. It provides moral and spiritual truths through situations children can relate to. Teaching God's Word to the children you love. Join the Superbook DVD Club and receive Superbook's newest episodes as they're available, plus 2 copies to share with others, all for your gift of only $25. Get Superbook today and watch the miracles happen.
Every day, people are connecting on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Now you can be part of the conversation and connect on topics you care about through 700 Club Interactive. log on to Facebook, Twitter, or go to YouTube and share your opinions, your prayer requests, and your videos while making friends in our community.
Well, welcome to the show.
Join the conversation on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. 700 Club Interactive. Be a part of the show.